Hey, good morning YouTube. We're out here for another gun hunt in Maryland. Out here on some public land. It's about 30 degrees right now. Wind's gusting at times. We'll give it a shot, see what happens. See what we can find.
Good morning YouTube. We're out today. First week of gun season here in Maryland. We got the 350 Legend ready to go. We're set up on the ground because it's a little bit of change of pace and it's really cold and I wasn't sure.
Yeah.
Alright folks, that was a completely a wild fiasco. I'm set up in my drainage spot, one of my go-to spots, and I see this little doe run out. She stops about 60 yards and some dudes start firing off from uphill down towards my area. Rounds cracking off. Started screaming, hollering, the little doe stares back at them. And then a minute later after that, this good-sized buck comes running out about 50 yards broadside. Shoot at it, starts running, shoot at it again, pretty sure I hit it. I mean, I know it's down. I think I hit it on the second one, but it might have been the first shot, I'm not too sure. But he ran off, he's piled up. It's a good 9 point. So solid buck, I'm gonna go get it and show you guys. Here he is, folks. Oh, what a tank. What a tank. So, great success. Shot a nice 9-pointer. Good body, good rack. Very happy with it. It's got a split brow tine. Gives it that extra kicker. It was a double lung shot, actually. So, not a bad shot. Went about 40 yards before piling up with the 350 Legend. 180 grained Winchester XPs. So, solid round. Solid round. Scary. It's kicking my butt. Well, that was a fun hunt. We got the 9-point back to the truck. We got him loaded up. We're gonna take him to the taxidermist and probably get him mounted. So pretty exciting stuff. That's buck number 2 for the year. We'll take a break for a day or two and get back after it. Stay tuned. All right. So that last time I was on, where I shot that, what I would say is a huge 9-point, it was chaos. I was set up on the ground facing the south. Some guys came in from the east and were pushing deer around. I heard him shoot about 30 minutes before I shot my buck. And then just before my buck came out, there was a whole big flurry of shooting right before that doe appeared that you'll see in the footage here or have seen. I started yelling because they were shooting in my direction and I was downhill from them and there was deer in between me and them. Probably one of the scariest moments I've had while deer hunting as far as, you know, other hunters. so I wasn't even really excited when I saw the buck. But I figured when that buck came in, I had no idea how big it was. I figured I was going to shoot. It had more than 3 points on one side, so it was, you know, the minimum requirement for that extra tag type deal. Not extra tag, but just for a good tag. And also I wanted to shoot to let them know, like, I'm here. They already stopped when I was yelling, but it got really sketchy because in the video you'll hear, they start shooting again. Well, when I talked to them, I thought they were shooting at the buck that I shot. In the video you see another bigger buck, which the buck I shot was downhill. They weren't shooting at that buck, they're shooting at the buck on the video, which is uphill from where I was. And 80 yards away, so, which is another good sized buck. I didn't realize there were two bucks. When I was talking to them, they were like, yeah, it was white horned. I was like, well, the buck I shot wasn't really white horned. Needless to say, two different bucks, slight difference. So definitely changed the way I looked at that hunt afterwards, because, you know, I don't know what better outcome I could have had. You know, I shot a nice buck. Would have been nice not to have people shoot in the general direction of me, but it is what it is, I guess. I don't know. It was nice, though, talking to them. They're decent folks. Just glad it worked out. So, yeah, those two bucks, they're shooting at the other one, which is pretty cool. So, just wanted to update you on this.